This might be the most important video that I'm gonna create this year. Nowadays, the demand for content, particularly video content, is the highest that it's ever been. And if you're anything like me, or that guy, you're trying to capitalize on it for your career and your business before the AI robots take everything over and we can't have nice things anymore. So in today's video, we're gonna talk about how to get clients. Because if you want to afford the fancy camera gear that you can either review or shoot your next film with, you're going to need some money. And the best way to do that is actually doing some client work. So the first thing you want to put into your mind when you're trying to get new clients for your business is the fact that they actually don't care about the videos themselves. Businesses are in the interest of solving problems, and using content and video content or photography is a way of solving different problems for the business so they can make money and they're willing to pay you for you to be able to do that. Oftentimes, your clients aren't necessarily going to care about the camera gear that you're going to be using or the artistry that goes into a shot. They just want to make sure that the end product that you're going to get for them either brings them brand awareness, it helps them with lead generation, or it helps them create some sales. Next thing you want to do is actually break down the types of videos that you like making the most or the ones that you're the best at and sell those as individual items to clients. Now, I know that budgets are variable and it's really hard to nail down the actual price of a particular project and it gets a little bit confusing sometimes, but that's just as confusing for a client as it is for you to figure out with little information. So something that I like doing is actually compartmentalizing the different types of videos that I create, from interviews to vertical content to product demos, and then I actually make those into itemized lists so when I present them to clients, they have an exact idea of what the finished product's going to look like and a ballpark range of what they're going to pay for that particular video. And now when somebody asks you how much does it cost for a video, you can actually give them a list of the types of different videos that they can hire you out to do, and you don't have to worry about deleting the Instagram thread anymore because you actually have an answer. Wait, am I the only one that does that? The easy way that I've been able to weed out clients that might not be able to meet the budget requirements that I need and also work on projects that I actually want to work on is setting something called a minimum level of engagement. And that means if you want to get paid for a particular type of video project, just tell them. Have a bottom ceiling of the lowest amount of money that you're willing to work for a particular video project. That way, if someone isn't able to meet up to that standard, no harm, no foul, you can just move on and look for new clients, and that person at least knows exactly how much you cost in order to get a project done. And what it does is create a standard for your work. Instead of the guessing game and trying to ask what their budget is and they're asking for your rate and you're going back and forth until the conversation eventually goes nowhere, if you just set a minimum rate and saying this is how much it's going to cost for me to do this project at the minimum and it only goes up from there, it gives a client an idea of the least amount of money that they're actually going to end up spending and they can make an educated decision instead of having a long dragged out conversation that honestly we're all a little bit frustrated with. Now, because video is in the interest of solving problems of a particular business, you also need proper context in terms of which videos are going to work for which particular client. And contextualizing the different content that you offer is a really great way to show potential clients that you know exactly what you're doing, not just from composition, lighting, and editing, but also exactly how you're using videos to solve their problems. For example, some clients actually have a lot of video content already made up, but they're posting on the wrong platforms or in the wrong ways that aren't generating them results. Shorter form vertical video is gonna be a little bit easier to be consumed by younger audiences. So if you are looking for those quick 8 to 10 second reels, that's gonna be effective with companies that work really well with younger audiences. Now on the flip side, if you're working with a company that's working with an older audience or an older consumer, you might wanna get really good at creating content types that are suitable for that older audience. For example, you might be more likely to shoot in the landscape 16:9. But it might be actually more effective as older audiences might not be on TikTok all the time. If you want to get really good at contextualizing your video offerings to your clients, do some research into finding out what their target audience is, what platforms are already sharing on, and then when you bring that concept to your client, it feels like you're actually speaking their language, which makes it more than likely that they're actually going to hire you as opposed to somebody else that just does video. Sometimes when you're talking to a client about a particular video project and you and they're really excited about it, the budget just doesn't add up. Now, what I'm not recommending is just dropping your price for no reason, but you could also barter services and barter product in exchange for the video content that you make for them. Now, something that I've learned when I'm talking to clients is that I don't discount products arbitrarily. When I'm sending over quotes for video projects, I don't hold back in terms of what the pricing actually is to get the best product possible for that particular client. And when the money just isn't there, I try to find a halfway point where they can save a little bit, but I also need something that's not monetary in value for exchange. Now, if you haven't noticed, I do shoot and edit a lot of fitness video. And sometimes when I'm talking to a client, the money just isn't there in exchange for them to have the quality that I can produce on a regular basis. However, they do own gym space. And if I want to do reviews views in a real life situation, I do need places and environments where I can shoot their content at the best of my ability. But if I had to pay the actual upfront cost of rent out some of these spaces, I would be spending thousands of dollars. If I have a certain amount of money it's going to cost to do a video project with a client, I would just subtract the hours and the money that I would need to actually rent the space from the original invoice, and that way I am going to get some money at the end of the day, but I'm also going to have a space where I could shoot my own content, and eventually at a later date I actually might end up making that back. This is incredibly important for you guys that might be working with clients that might not have the budgets, but they do have other assets like a space that you can film your filmmaking content or your review videos in there in exchange. Now I get it, people don't want to work for free, and it's something that a lot of people stray away from, but having beta testers for the types of video content that you want to make is a great way to actually prove to other people that it can work. Now this is pretty much the same as having spec projects, but instead of working on different spec projects and concepts as they go, you actually have clients that you're going to beta test to types of content that you want to make for their competitors or other people in the same industry as them. This is really great because you can find out what works and what doesn't. And when you have content that just seems to work, it's going to be a higher value, and in the long run, it's going to make you a little bit more money. Next, and some of you guys might not like this, but social media is going to be your friend. More and more businesses are actually communicating on social media, from Instagram to YouTube channels and even having TikToks, and they're using social media as a medium to generate sales, to build up leads, and to sell products. And if you think about it, owning a video business or freelancing is kind of the same thing. You're trying to get people to hire you for video, you're trying to get into different spaces that could generate revenue for you, and some of you might be starting off other ventures like starting up a YouTube channel. Now again, to each their own, you don't necessarily have to be on any of the social media platforms, but what I will say is it's going to put you in a better position versus had you not had done it in the first place. Now when you're talking to clients and everything is going well, you sound like you know what you're talking about, and they keep nodding their head and saying yes, this is probably the time to ask for the sale. Now this does sound incredibly obvious and straightforward, but oftentimes when we're having client conversation and things are going really well, sometimes we forget to ask if this person actually wants to hire us or we're just having a good conversation. You might be surprised by the amount of people that you might have lost as clients by simply not asking where do we go from here. When things are going right, when clients are saying yes to you, when you're on a phone conversation, everything is going well, that's an indicator that that person actually might want to hire you for your next project. So don't forget to ask for the sale. Now those are a bunch of tips in terms of getting clients, but here's some things that I keep in mind so I can end up keeping them. Number one is never stop looking for work. Now you might feel really happy and comfortable with the current clients you have and the type of work that you're doing, but in today's day and age, things can turn around fast. Now that doesn't necessarily mean signing a whole bunch of new contracts and burning yourself out eventually, but you always want to leave the door open to have new conversations and make new connections. But if you have so much work that you can't take on that next project, you could also pass it down to somebody in your creative circle and taking a finder's fee, which means that you're actually getting paid for being the connection point between a client and having someone actually do the work for you instead of you having to take everything on by yourself. Now the second thing, and we're gonna take a little bit of a page out of Beyoncé's book. And that's pitching a retainer agreement for the clients that you're working with. Chances are when you're working on a video project and everything goes well, they're probably going to want to work with you again. And to be honest, don't block the blessing and actually offer a retainer style agreement so you could actually make content for them on a regular basis. Now with creating retainer agreements, you want to build those things around different concepts instead of just being somebody that's going to be a pylon, because it's easy to replace different pylons. Have a retainer agreement that's going to be a little bit different or better than someone else might offer them later on in the future. And lastly is honestly just be a good person on set. The video business is the relationship business, and you'd be so surprised how far you can get with just being a good person on set. Showing up on time, showing up and doing the best that you can, staying late, and doing some of the little things that offer as a courtesy to your clients goes a long way. And sometimes clients outgrow you, and sometimes you outgrow clients, but if you leave them a lasting positive impression, you actually might get recommended by another client that might be able to be bigger for your business and bigger for your career. As somebody that never went to film school and learned a lot of things I know about filmmaking and videography on the internet, a lot of spaces I have absolutely no business in. But what I like doing is creating a vibe on set and creating an experience for my clients so not only they're happy, but they're more than willing to recommend me to other people, which is the basis of how I get a lot of my work in the first place. Now that being said, I've taught you everything that I know in terms of getting clients and what I actually do to keep them. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and you actually put some of these things forward in order for you to earn more money for your business, to bring yourself that much closer into a full-time career, or to actually increase the business that you already have. Now I know this isn't a tech video, but the YouTube algorithm does think that you might like this video right over here. So be sure to check that out, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.